Hi, I'm Ryan with Nelson Northwest, and in this video, we're going to take a look at troubleshooting Amatec BW Controls 1500 series relays. At Nelson Northwest, we're frequently asked to help troubleshoot liquid level control systems with BW Controls relays. In this video, we're going to provide some tips for troubleshooting these systems. In general, 1500 relays are very reliable, but they've been around since the 1980s, so there's been plenty of time for systems with these relays to develop problems. When level control systems with 1500s fail, by far the most common cause is the electrode circuit, and operating with a faulty electrode circuit can cause premature wear and ultimately failure of the relay. First, let's troubleshoot the relay itself. To do this, we're going to need a slotted screwdriver and a good multimeter. And remember, there are hundreds of volts on the terminals, so this should be done by a qualified technician. We'll start with the basics. Does the relay have the correct line voltage on terminals 3 and 4? Are the connections on the relay secure and corrosion-free? Are the electrodes in the tank clean and reasonably corrosion-free? If you're using an electrode holder with connections, are the connections in good shape? Is there a good signal ground from the relay to the liquid? This should be either a ground electrode or a solid connection from the relay to a metal tank. If this is a new installation, remember that the load contacts on this relay just provide a dry contact closure. Hooking the two terminals of a contact to the two terminals of a starter coil or single-phase pump won't work. It's a bit like a light switch. You have to put power on one side, and it will just switch it on and off. For new installations, also make sure that the electrodes are within the acceptable distance from the relay. Too far, and the relay may not drop out correctly or may fail prematurely. Next, let's rule out faults in the relay. Turn off the power to the relay. We'll have to disconnect the wiring, so make a wiring diagram of the relay. Mark any unmarked wires, and take a good photo showing the connections. Disconnect all the wires from the relay except the line voltage on terminals 3 and 4. Measure continuity for each of the contacts. Normally open contacts should read open, and normally closed should read very low resistance. If the continuity is incorrect, the relay is probably defective. Replacing bad contacts may be an option if the rest of the relay is in good shape. Otherwise, replace the relay. Now turn the power back on to the relay. The relay should not pull in. Continuity of the contacts should be the same. Measure the voltage across the secondary terminals, 7 and 8. It should be roughly equal to the rated secondary voltage. A bit higher or lower is okay, but if the voltage is significantly lower than the rated voltage, with no other connections on the secondary coil, the relay is probably defective. Now, turn the power off again. Put a jumper wire across the secondary terminals 7 and 8. Turn the power back on. The relay should now pull in. If the relay does not pull in with jumpered secondary coils, it's defective. Now measure continuity for each of the contacts. Normally open contacts should read very low resistance, and normally closed should now read open. If the continuity is incorrect, the relay is probably defective. You'll need to replace contacts or replace the entire relay. Now turn the power off again. If no problems were found with the relay, remove the jumper and reconnect the wires on all the terminals. The problem is most likely in the electrode circuit. If the relay tests okay, make a thorough inspection of the electrode circuit. Electrodes should be clean and free of corrosion. Check all connections inside and outside of the tank for low resistance. This includes wire connections on wire suspension electrodes. Make sure that the signal ground from the relay goes either to a dedicated ground electrode or has a good connection to a metallic tank. One trick you can use to check electrode circuits is to power off the relay and connect two electrodes together at the tank. Disconnect the electrodes at the relay and test the resistance between the two. If the resistance is high, the wiring is suspect. One final trick, if no problems have been identified so far, but the system is still not working, you can simulate the electrode circuit in a bucket. This will help to isolate problems with the relay from problems with the electrode circuit. First, fill a bucket with the same water that you're sensing. Cut lengths of insulated wire to simulate your electrodes. In this case, we have three. Strip the wires and wire the relay per your wiring diagram. For this demo, we've wired a light to simulate pump operation. Suspend the ends of the wires in your bucket. And remember that when we energize the relay, these will have high voltage. You can move the wires up and down to simulate changing water level and see if the relay pulls in at the correct points. In addition to the tips we've provided here, you can find troubleshooting information in the 1500 Relay Installation Manual. The manual ships with new relays and is also available on our website. If you get stuck, we're always happy to answer questions.